I'm going to uncheck the G. I just want to represent this graph here. Can you see what I'm doing now? I just want to represent the potential, okay? So now, based on what I have heard so far, it should be negative 6.67, okay? Because I already tell you that in your model, you can avoid multiplying to the power of minus 11. So therefore, it will be just that number. Multiply by 100?
300.
300, okay, let's try. Divide by R. Okay, enter. Okay, perfect match. Okay, for this side. Okay, so in other words, you are relatively confident that the modeling part is accurate. Okay, now how many of you are unhappy with this? How many of you are unhappy with this? Why this side is up and then your model is up, but actually the potential is down? If you are unhappy with this, there is one trick you can do, but this is going beyond the syllabus. Do you want to listen? Do you want to hear? Okay. In mathematics, there's something called absolute. It's basically your modulus. Okay? So you can come here. You can type in something called absolute bracket R. Okay, then that should give you the perfect fit. Okay, so maths can be used to strengthen the physics. Okay? But then, of course, like all good students, you want to learn more, but bearing in mind that this is a little bit out. That's why I will bring it in as a way to excite the student, but seriously speaking, it is not required. Okay? Yep. That's why I'm always online checking, hoping that people will post comment. Yeah. Okay? Or you can ask your teachers when you meet them, and then they can find out from me.
Can you suggest something like a tips or what? Some kind of
potential, okay? So the gradient to the potential has an implication to your field. The magnitude of this gradient is exactly equal to your field strength. Okay? So by interacting with this, you can also do your model and all that. But I think the visualization will allow you to figure this out. I hope so.
How do you get a gradient?
Okay, come, let's take a look. Okay, gradient in physics is called d phi over dr. Because this graph is called a phi graph, right? d phi over dr is equal to negative 0.58 to the power of minus 11. Correct? So you look at this number, minus 0.58. Where is it indicated that? I have a force here, and you have a force.
I cannot see the
tangent. This tangent is not
seen. As in the
because it's too long, is it?
Misrepresentation. If it is wrong, it will
for you it is wrong. Okay,
what is the yellow thing?
Which yellow thing? The plus. This one is the fire plus thing. Okay. Press the fire plus. Okay, press it once. Then you will release.
Oh my gosh.
See it flies out because you just given it initial speed. You fire the thruster so it shoots
fire.
Up.
Fire.
Yeah.
Fire.
So it's like a step
or something. It is just to simulate increase in the momentum in the direction that it was. Let's say the rocket is moving this way, you shoot some exhaust gases so that you give the rocket a little bit more speed. And you notice you will not go in a circle. Okay. And depending on the condition you give it, it might even be able to escape the gravity pull of it. Yeah, I'm going to bring it back. Okay, so again, let's try another scenario. Can you select this option called escape velocity? As r equal to the radius of the earth and theta is 0 degrees. Okay. Can you just fire it off and see what happens?
It's not coming back.
Okay. You just release it and see what happens. Okay? So you can wait for it to come back, but it will not. Because this is the. Okay, you look carefully at the way I design the sim, okay? If you look carefully when you select this, escape velocity, yeah? Now, can you see the number here? Oh, which is too small for you, but. The number I put here is actually 11200. Okay? It's about 11 kilometers, 11.2 kilometers per second. That is the theoretical value for any object escaping from this planet. Okay, if you can check it out, Wikipedia, these numbers are all there. Okay? So when you release, you will escape. Okay? Now you can obviously, after this, obviously, you can now try a different value. Okay, if you want, okay, so the question is, I want to wait for it to come back. How can I wait for it to come back? I can do this, okay? I have selected. Now that I have gotten used to this simulation, I can select zero. I can come here, change from 11,200, I can change it to a lesser number. Let's say 10,000. Okay, enter and fire. Okay, now this on the other hand will come back. This will come back because the speed I key in was 11,000 only. It doesn't have the extra 200 to escape.